What's up, YouTube? It's Swamplord again, and I'm going to be cracking my Oath of the Gatewatch booster box. So I hope you are ready. So I know I am. Let's get this going here. Let's see if I can't get another expedition. We shall see. Okay. Try not to make too many crinkle noises so the microphone doesn't flip a shit on me. Okay. So, shall we? If you saw my fat pack opening for Oath of the Gatewatch, I got a stupid green spin down for Battle for Zendikar. It wasn't even for this set, so that upset me. No pun intended. Make a Stand, Grasp of Darkness, Tears of Valakut, and Dread Defiler. Ooh! That's alright. That is a foil bucket, or teacup, whatever you want to call it. Awesome. But the rare, Dread Defiler, 7 for 6, 8. Pay 4, exile target creature card from your graveyard. Target opponent loses life equal to the exiled creature's power. Interesting. I don't think I've read that card. That definitely is going to be mean and limited. Okay. So I'm just going to cruise through these here. Embodiment of Insight, Spatial Contortion, cool card. Baleth Pup. Oh yeah, Thought Not Seer. Good stuff. I'm sure most of you know what this is now, or by now. 4/4/4/4. When it enters the battlefield, target opponent reveals his or her hand. You choose a 9-land card from it and exile it. And when this guy leaves the battlefield, target opponent draws a card. Very good. It is very good indeed. Ooh. Give me some trouble here. Okay. You know what? I didn't even look again. I didn't get any wastes in my fat pack from any of the boosters. Reaver Drone, Meandering River, Baleth Null, and Corrupted Crossroads. Okay. Comes in untapped, tap to add a colorless, and pay one to add any color to cast a devoid spell. So basically, Eldrazi, Mana Confluence, or City of Ass, you know, it's cool. It's good for standard for sure. People can splash for colors for their colorless friends. So, Meandering River, Iona's Blessing, Visions of Brutality, and Matter Reshaper is another pretty cool card. 3/4/3/2. When he dies, reveal the top card of your library. You may put that card onto the battlefield if it's a permanent card with converted mana cost 3 or less. Otherwise, put it into your hand. And here's the foil rare. Remorseless Punishment. Very strange card. Basically, you can have him lose 10 life, I guess, essentially. Target opponent loses 5 life unless that player discards 2 cards or sacrifices a creature or planeswalker and repeat this process one more time. A bit weird. So not just, you know, lose 10 life, but if they're in bad shape, then it could end up going that way. So, what do we have? Hey, there's the first wastes. Yay. Put that aside. Sweet. I know I'm excited over a common, but hey, man. Cyclone Sire. Relentless Hunter. Void Shatter. And Jory N. Ruin Diver. It's a pretty cool card I'm a bit excited about. And what does she do? So, 3-drop, 2-3. Whenever you cast your second spell each turn, draw a card. Really, nothing wrong with that. She's legendary, though. She's a badass merfolk wizard, so there's that. Any more wastes? No? Fine. See if I care. Allied reinforcements, Mind Melter, Step Glider, and Drana's Chosen. 4-drop for a 2-2 with Cohort. Tap, put an untapped ally you control. Oh, sorry. tap an untapped ally you control. Put a 2-2 Black Zambi token. So that's what all these are for. The Zambers. Interesting. I was kind of wondering why there were so many. Oh, look, Negate was reprinted. Ha ha. All right. Cyclone Sire. Storm Chaser Mage. Devouring Flames. Ooh, and Eilie, I believe is how you pronounce her name. She does good stuff. Orzhov, 2-3. Death Touch, pay 1, sacrifice another creature. You gain life equal to their toughness. And 1 into Orzhov, white and black. Sacrifice another creature. Exile target now and permanent. Activate this ability only if you have at least 10 life or... Oh, 10 life more than your starting total. Okay. A bit silly. But, I mean, you might not use that second ability a ton, but... The first one can most likely get you out of a tough spot. So if you have your... I guess if you have something lined up, it'll work out for you. Another Meandering River, Stoneforge Acolyte, Jiraga Auxiliary, yeah, and Tyrant of Valakut. 7-drop for a 5/7 dragon with a search cost of 5. When it enters the battlefield, if you paid search... The search costs, you deal 3 damage to target creature or player. Certainly limited playable. No doubt. But other than that, EDH Dragons. There you go. I don't really know. What the hell is going on with this pack? Got extra debris flying everywhere. Ooh, Ancient Crab. Okay. Pyromancer's Assault, Thought Harvester, another Step Glider, oh cool, and Gladeheart Cavalry, it's a big ass elf. I just like having elves, I don't know, gonna make an EDH deck eventually. So 7-drop, 6/6, so when it enters the battlefield, support 6, whenever a creature you control with a 1/1 counter on it dies, you gain 2 life, so... Oh, yeah. Limited, that is a bit hard to deal with, I would imagine, but at the same time, it would probably be a bit hard to cast sometimes, but I'm not sure. In terms of limited play, I've only done Magic Origins one time and Battle for Zendikar many times online, so nothing exciting here. Overwhelming Denial. I believe it is just counter target spell. It can't be countered by spells or abilities. Huh. So, it's basically the original counter spell, I suppose. Whoops. An original counter spell from the old days, if you pay the surge cost. But whatevs. And, let's see. Embodiment of Insight, Special Contortion, Malakir Soothsayer, and Deceiver of Form. Hey, a foil, Reckless Bushwhacker. Okay. 7 for an 8-8 at the beginning of your turn. Reveal top card of your library. Was that? That wasn't the same as this. Oh, okay. Dread Defiler. Sorry. I was like, wait a minute. if a creature card is revealed this way, you may have creatures you control other than this card become copies of that card until end of turn. You may put that card on the bottom of your library. Mm-hmm. All right. Either way, 7 for an 8-8, it's, you know, yeah. Still pretty good. Spider. Eh? Oh. Ulamog. Kozilek. Spooky. Will we get a Kozilek? I do not know. Grip of the Royal. Chitinous Cloak. Stoneforge Acolyte. And Ruins of Orin Reef. I got one of these in my fat pack. Comes in tapped. You can tap to add a colorless, or tap to put a 1-1 counter on a colorless creature that entered the battlefield that turn. Pretty cool. Oh no, I ripped Chandra's face off. Ah! Another crab. I like this card. Very good. Prophet of Distortion. Definitely seems good for a limited. Strider Harness. Gift of Tusks. And Oath of Jace. Alright. So, what does Mr. Jace's Oath do? 3-drop. Legendary enchantment, of course. When it enters the battlefield, draw 3 cards and discard 2 cards. At the beginning of your upkeep, scry X, where X is the number of planeswalkers you control. It's good for the card draw, I suppose, and I don't know. It's most likely not going to do a whole lot in limited, because you would need to open a planeswalker in addition to play Oath of Jace, and the planeswalkers are green and red, so, Got the Bushwhacker, Troll, Balathnol, and a Hissing Quagmire. That's probably what it sounds like when I take a dump. Just saying. Enters tapped. Tap for Golgari colors. Or pay 3 and it becomes a 2/2 with Death Touch. Okay. Okay. Alright. Yay, another waste. I was just going to say, I don't think I've seen another one in a little bit. Reaver Drone. Submerged Boneyard. Ruin in Their Wake. And Call the Gatewatch. So, sorcery for 3. Search your library for a Planeswalker card. Reveal and put in your hand, then shuffle. Again, limited, I don't know. If you're in white, I guess if you got a Gideon from Battle for Zendikar in your sealed pool, then maybe, but I don't know. Very strange. Bushwhacker, Troll, Ruin, Goblin, Spooky Dwellers. 5 for a 4/4 with Menace. When it enters the battlefield, you may cast target instant or sorcery card with converted mana cost 3 or less from your graveyard without paying its mana cost. If that card would be put in your graveyard this turn, exile it instead. Snapcaster Goblin. Just kidding. Sort of. I don't know. Doot, doot, doot. Seed Guardian. Bushman. Tranquil Expanse. Void Grafter. Crush of Tentacles. Oh, dear. And a foil McKindy Aeronaut. Foil common. Not getting any exciting foils, really, but it's alright. 6 for sorcery. You can pay the Surge for 5. Return all non-land permanents to their owner's hands. If the Surge cost was paid, you put an Octopus token out. Excuse me. You get to borrow Kiora's octopus and, you know, start beating some face with that. Nothing wrong with a little bit of ass whipping, if you know what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Alright, my commons pile is nearly toppling over. Prophet of Distortion, Strider Harness, Immobilizer Eldrazi, and Sphinx of the Final Word. Back-to-back blue mythics, I guess that's a thing. And, oh, cool. Foil Crumbling Vestige, and also back-to-back foil commons in the same pack. Well, this is a 7-drop 5-5. It can't be countered, flying, hexproof, instant, and sorcery spells you control can't be countered by spells or abilities. Pretty powerful card. If you can get that thing out there, that's, yeah. Bad news for those Eldrazis. Or just Eldrazi, I don't know. Hey, is that the guy getting burnt in Radiant Flames artwork? Probably. Yay, wastes. Whee! Oops, sorry, banged into the stinking iPad. Seen those, Bonds of Mortality. Another Wandering Fumarole. I got one of those in my fatty pack. The is it creature land or man land or slow land? Whatever you want to call it, land. I still think it could be a girl. How do you know? There's no way to know. It's a freaking land. Immolating Glare. Flare Drone, Tears of Velikut, Oath of Chandra. Aw, she's so cute. So, what does she do? 2-drop enchantment. When it enters the battlefield, it deals 3 damage to target creature and opponent controls. At the beginning of each end step, if a planeswalker enters the battlefield under your control, it deals 2 damage to each opponent. Again, the second one, I don't know. But it is basically a lightning bolt for 2, so, And it just sits there on the field. Might go in a burn deck for me sometime. Don't you near. And Pyromancer's Assault. It's also an enchantment. Havoc Sower, it's a pretty cool card. Void Grafter. And Deep Fathom Skulky. 6-drop for a 4/4. Whenever a creature you control deals combat damage to a player, you may draw a card, and you can pay 4 to have target creature become unblockable this turn. Alright, we are cruising. If you guys watching aren't already subscribed, please consider doing so. It would be much appreciated. Got tons of magic videos on here. Ooh, Reflector Mage. That's a cool card. I think that's the first one. Iona's Blessing. And Zendikar Resurgent. I believe we just opened that. Oh no, that was in the fat pack. Damn it. I'm recording these in the same evening, so forgive me. So what that does is a 7-drop enchantment. Whenever you tap a land for mana, you can add 1 mana extra of any type that the land produced. And whenever you cast a creature spell, draw a card. It's definitely good, it's just a big green card like usual. Another crab! I don't know why there's so many crabs. Looking for crabs! Tranquil Expanse, Bonds of Mortality, Weapons Trainer, and Munda's Vanguard. Throat's getting dry here. Open this in the fat pack. Has cohort, tap an untapped ally you control. Put a 1/1 counter on each creature. So you have to tap this guy and an untapped ally you have. And then everybody gets a 1/1. Definitely limited sauce right there. Big time. Big time limited sauce. Oh yeah, wastes. Gotta get a pauper waste deck going. Timber Gorge weapons trainer, sorry. This is Judgment and Stonehaven Outfitter. Whoops, that doesn't go there. None of this. Everything's in the wrong pile. I got shit flying in my face and I don't like it. So, he's a 2-drop for 2/2. Equipped creatures you control get +1/+1. Whenever a equipped creature you control dies, draw a card. I get some equipment allies stuff going in limited, who knows. Get a few bone saws in there and might be doing the do. Ooh, another waste. Cool. Alright. Cliffhaven Vampire. Relentless Hunter. Flaying Tendrils. And Mythic. General Tazri. 5/3/4. Legendary. When he enters the battlefield. Is that a he? I think it's a she. Sorry. It's hard to tell. I need glasses. When this person enters the battlefield, search your library for an ally creature card, reveal it, put it in your hand, and shuffle your library. And then you can pay one of each color, and ally creatures you control get +X/+X until end of turn, where X is the number of colors among those creatures. Huh. Strange. Maybe if you get some wacky five-color ally deck in limited or standard constructed, I don't ask me. Because you could potentially do some wacky things, I suppose. Allied Reinforcements, Visions of Brutality, Void Shatter, and Needle Spires. Man, getting lots of rares I got in my damn fatty pack. But tis alright. Sometimes it's just better to get rare lands than bulk rares from starter decks, so that's a thing. Ugh. Sweet Jesus. Ripping pepperoni headphone users. Relief Captain. I relieved myself before making the video. You know, I took a pee. Essence Depleter. Devouring Flames. Sorry, I felt like that was worth sharing. And Sifter of Skulls. What? 4/4/3. When another non-token creature you control dies, put a Scion. Yeah, okay. That's it. It's just got all the extra verbiage on there. So, that's definitely limited playable. Reason I keep saying this stuff is I'm kind of trying to give myself ideas as I open these, because on Friday, I will be playing the pre-release for online for this set. And as I said, yay, waste. And as I said in my Fat Pack opening of this set, for whatever reason, it's 2 or 3 weeks behind online, so, yeah. Null Caller, Cinder Barons, Havoc Sower. Oh, cool, Eldrazi Displacer, that's a nice pull. And a Pulse of Murasa, foil common. Okay, this is the only white Eldrazi, I believe, which is pretty damn cool. 3/4/3/3, pay 3, exile another target creature, and return it back. So, it's a Flicker Drazi, there you go. Flicker Wisp Eldrazi, something like that. Sorta. I know Flicker Wisp is 2 white and 1 colorless, so this guy over here is more splashable. That's probably why he's a rare. Yay, wastes. Well, now we're getting a bunch. Seedman, Walker of the Waste, Tears of Valakut, and Captain's Shoes. I mean, Claws. Foil. Weapons Trainer Lady. So, 2 for the artifact. Equipped creature gets +1/+0 whenever they attack. Put an ally tapped and attacking. Okay. Interesting. Could be fun. Yikes. I am making a big mess with these booster packs. I've seen people getting damaged cards. I don't think I've seen any in mine, so I guess I'm lucky. Null Caller, Cinder Barons, Flaying Tendrils, and Endbringer. Yeah, I did not read this one. I think, this is a pretty good card. Untap Endbringer during each other player's untap step. Tap Endbringer deals 1 damage to target creature or player. I can't speak. Pay 1 and tap. Target creature can't attack or block. And pay 2, tap, draw a card. Good stuff. Alright, down to the last 6 packs. I'm so excited to start playing some more. It's been a while. It's always exciting when a new set comes out. Me like it. Boiling Waters, just kidding, Roiling. Draga Auxiliary, Unity of Purpose. Oh dear, Hadrian Alignment. That's scary. 3-drop enchantment, Hexproof. At the beginning of your upkeep, you may reveal your hand. If you do, you win the game. If you have this card in exile in your hand, in your graveyard, and on the battlefield. And you can pay 2 to scry. Oh dear. I don't know. I would laugh hysterically if somebody manages to pull that off in draft. If there's enough of those opened and passed to the person and they take them, that would be some shit, honestly. Wastes. I got my commons pile flapping away over here. Now I would call it boiling. It's not. Kindness Cloak. You need a purpose. Yeah, we got Chandra. Okay. Nice. This is the first Chandra I've ever opened. And I have a KMC Perfect Fit. Bam. Oh, yeah. So, what does Miss Chandra do? She's a 6-drop Planeswalker with 4 loyalty. Put 2 3-1 elemental tokens with haste on the battlefield. Exile them at the end. Pay 0, discard all cards in your hand, then draw that many plus 1. Minus X deals X damage to each creature. Definitely a cool card. Nice. Alright. Pack number 4 out of 4 left. Ugh. Come on now. Yeah. That's pretty cool. Take the Chandra. I've never opened a Chandra or a Nissa, so I have chances for both of those, I suppose, in this set. Relief Captain, Essence Depleter, Thought Harvester, and another Eilie. Oh, I thought, for some reason, I thought that was a Foil Wastes. Jesus! Alright. Almost to the end. Almost to the end. Oh my god. Sorry if the video's going a little long. Not familiar with the set yet. I will be in due time. Gazelle's Toll Collector, Gift of Tusks, Mind Melter. Oh, nice. We got a Mirror Pool. Mythic Rare. So, this is a cool card. Enters tapped, tap to add a colorless, pay 3, sacrifice it, copy target instant or sorcery spell you control, and you may choose new targets for that copy. Pay 5, tap, sacrifice, put a token on the battlefield that's a copy of target creature you control. That is fun shit right there. Like, you want another Ulamog? Oh, okay. Just kidding. It'd definitely be cool for Desolation Twin if you can pull that off. Warping Whale. Oh, cool. Mina and Den Wildborn. Got pretty much all the legendary creatures, I think. Whoops. Or a hell of a lot of them. 4/4/4/4. You may play an additional land on each of your turns. Pay red, green, return a land to the owner's hand. Target creature gains trample. Cool card. Last pack. Oh no, it's empty. Alright. So, what will we get? Is our wasteland in here, or our ancient tomb, or something cool? We shall see. Wow, no waste in the last pack. I am sad, and my commons are flying away again. Stab it. Alright, Meandering River, Battle Pup, Flare Drone, and Oath of Nyssa. That's a good oath to have, I would say. Not too bad. One drop. When it enters the battlefield, look at the top three cards of your library. God, the text is so small, I can't read it. You may reveal a creature, land, or planeswalker from among them and put it in your hand. Put the rest on the bottom of your library in any order. You may spend mana as though it were mana of any color to cast planeswalker spells. That's interesting. Very interesting. Oh boy. Let's look at the big mess over here. Oh my Jesus. There's all the... all the packs and the pile of things and stuff. So. Excuse me. Now what did we get? What did we get? Chandra. Foil Remorseless Punishment. Oath of Nyssa. Mina and Den, Mirror Pool, Eile, Hedron Alignment, Endbringer, Captain's Claws, Eldrazi Displacer, Sifter of Skulls, Needle Spires, General Tazri, Stonehaven Outfitter, Muna's Vanguard, Zendikar Resurgent, Deep Fathom Skulky, Oath of Chandra, Wandering Fumigated Rolls, yep, Sphinx of the Final Word. Crush of Tentacles. Damn, we got a lot of mythics. Goblin Dark Dwellers. Call the Gatewatch. Hissing Quagmire. Oath of Jace. Ruins of Oran Reef. Seaver of Form. Overwhelming Denial. Gladeheart Cavalry. It's Cavalry, not Calvary. Tyrant of Velikut. Eile, Eternal Pilgrim. Drain is Chosen. Jorian Ruin Diver. Mattery Shaper. Corrupted Crossroads. Thought Not Seer, yeah. And Dread Defiler. And. Yeah. That's awesome to get. Just saying. And the foil stuffs. Weapons Trainer, Pulse of Murasa, Crumbling Vestige, that's cool. McKindy Aeronaut, and Mr. Bushwacky. He's reckless and he's whacking bushes, so. Careful with that one. So. Just want to say thank you so much for watching, if you stuck around the entire time. And if you are not already subscribed, please consider popping that subscribe button. If you would like to share the video, please do. And stay tuned for more Magic the Gathering videos in the future, and more gameplay and or unboxing videos of other nerd things. So thanks for watching, guys. Have a good night. Peace.